Yo, it's Sway.
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 In the morning.
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 Only on Shade 45.
Wake your fuck ass up.
Yeah. Bitches.
All right, listen, man. There's another name that's synonymous. When you think of Houston and you think of the music scene, but even beyond that, you know, it was a lot of entrepreneurs that came out of Houston from the music scene, and one of them is sitting with me right now, and he has to be the most humble, down-to-earth person that I've met in coming out of the music game. The one, the only, the legendary, Paul Wall is
here. What it do? What's up, baby? Wall,
yeah.
What it do?
Yo. Paul, what up, man?
What's up, homie?
Oh, man, you look like 1.5 in front of me right now.
Hey,
man,
I'm feeling like 2.0 right now.
2.0,
man.
Right? Yeah, man. How about the grill? Do you got a grill for every day of the week?
Man,
or?
I do, actually.
You do, really?
I got a grill for every day of the week, man.
So you got the Friday grill on
today? Yeah, this is my all-star grill, my Friday grill.
Okay, the all-star grill.
They told me Kirk O'Banks is coming, so I said, okay, let me pull out my new grill so you I can show them.
Yeah, everybody stepped their game up. Few fellas left their girls at home. Kirko, when Kirko come in the room, all attention just, you know, go. Kirko, what up, baby?
Hey, we need to get him on the microphone so I can go take his Lambo out for a spin.
Okay. Yo, did he drive the Lambo?
I don't know. I'm about to go see as soon as he get on this
you
mic.
You drove the Lambo?
He said.
Okay, he didn't drive the Lambo today. Paul, man, you know, man, we've had a lot of people on the show today. We got a lot of people coming, man. What's been going on with Paul Wall?
Man, I've been daddy swagging more than anything, man. Uh-huh. Man, I love being a dad. It's something that I always wanted to be my whole life as a child. I couldn't wait to grow up and have kids and be a dad. So, daddy swagging right now, man, I'm just loving it. I can't wait today. I'm taking my kids to the rookie game. We're going to ball out at the dunk contest. So, you know, we get it in, man.
Now, how many kids you got now?
I got two. I got a son. He's about to be 7, and my little girl, she's 5.
Yeah, you
got
to see them, Heather B. They all got matching family grills, too, right?
Yeah. And everybody got J's. You know, the family that J's together stays together.
The family that J's together stays together, man. Well, you get your name when it comes to the Houston music scene is just one you cannot ignore, and you know, and I remember years ago, and I was talking to Mike Jones about this when we came out and did our My Block show on MTV.
I remember that.
And by the way, we got James Lucena and Rob Markman from MTV here too. We got a one stop shop, so if you make it down here, not only are you gonna get on Shade 45, you're gonna get on MTV as well. What is the status of that? The Houston scene was a stronger then than it is now. Although you got guys like Trey the Truth, Kirk O'Banks, you know, Boston George. You got a lot of guys, D-Lo, that are, you know, Uzi, that are uplifting the scene right now.
Yeah.
It seems like it's reemerging. But what happened in between time?
Well, you know, it seems like we all came from the underground. And us grinding underground, we built our fan base up and we built it to a spot to where we could take it to the next level. And we took it to the next level. And it seemed like everybody that was in the underground in college went to the pros, but nobody went on to college. So it seems like, you know, there's no more Final Four because ain't nobody playing in college no more.
Uh-huh.
But then you got people, you know, and everybody who say who's emerging now, if you ask any one of them, they've been grinding for a long time in this in one way or another. And you know, whether it's, you know, with rapping, like ask Kirk how long he's been rapping, or Uzi, or D-Lo, or even Boston George, this might be his first song, but he's been in the music game for a while doing it. So, you know, the underground scene is reemerging, and you see people from the underground from college going to the pros again because people going back to college. So, you know, it's a healthy type of cycle going on. So we need more underground to keep the pros going. We need more college players if we want the pros to keep getting better. So, you know, that's what we need.
Yeah, I like how you put that in a sports analogy, especially because it's NBA All-Star Weekend.
Yeah,
Paul Wall, man. He said, you hear this, Heather B?
I'm here. I'm loving it.
What's up, Heather B?
Hey, how you doing, Paul Wall?
I'm good. I got your grill ready.
Okay.
Ooh.
Now, how much did the jewelry business, if so, take away from the music business for you? Like, you seem like you're equally invested.
Man, I got a lot of hustles. This is just how I was raised. You know, you got to have a hustle for every season. Just like you got Jordans and you got a jacket when it's cold and you pull out your sandals and you flip-flop J's and hit the beach, you know, when it's warm. So I got to hustle. Sometimes it's music. Sometimes it's grills. Sometimes it's other things. Whatever, you know, I'm just getting money however I know how. And the jewelry is something I love to do.
Mm-hmm.
So why not make money off of it if I'm a good hustler and I'm good at selling it and I love it too? Why not do it? Me and Johnny Dane, we've been making money just for a long time.
For a long time. Little Johnny, man, he's as famous as any this rapper right now.
Man,
right?
He got more cameos and videos than I got.
Man, he's out selling you. You know
he is, man. He got an album coming too.
Yeah, you got an album coming out today. with Slim Thug, mm-hmm. and it's called
Welcome to Texas Part 3, Me, Slim Thug, and Mr. Rogers. Welcome to Texas Part 3. It's coming out in a couple hours, so be on the lookout for it.
It's Sway in the Morning, only on Shade 45.